Hello everyone. I welcome you to the lecture series of technical communication. Today we are going to start with lecture 12 of unit 2, that is about 7 C's of effective business writing. This is a very simple topic, yet very important topic to discuss. So first of all, we'll be talking about effective communication. Here, we will be talking about effective communication and then the 7 C's of effective communication, that is concreteness, completeness, clarity, conciseness, courtesy, correctness, and consideration. So let us move forward. First of all, what is effective communication? Effective communication takes place only when the listener clearly understands the message. Otherwise, there's no point of that communication when your receiver does not receive the information that you are sharing. So effective communication takes place only when a listener clearly understands the message that the speaker is intended to send. A speaker's message must be delivered clearly. It should be clear, concise, and clear so that it does not leave any sort of confusion in the mind of receiver. A listener must be an active listener. Now, it is not only on the part of sender, but also in the part of receiver, that he should be an active listener. He should not be disoriented towards here and there and should listen to the person or the sender, who is sending the information. It is applicable for both written as well as verbal communication. Moving further, first of all comes concreteness. So the first 7 C that we are talking about of writing effective business writing is concreteness. We should be concrete in our writing. How? Concrete communication implies being particular and clear rather than fuzzy and general. Concreteness strengthens the confidence. Concrete message has following features. What does it have? It has specific facts, figures to state. It makes use of words that are clear, that build the reputation. So when you are stating, when you are communicating with someone, you should not appear as if fuzzy or general. You should be concrete and specific and to the point when you are communicating. Then only your communication will be a successful communication. It should show your confidence. Also, you should state certain facts and figures to prove your point, whatever you are saying. It makes use of words that are clear. It should be clear that build the reputation. So concrete messages are never misinterpreted. Concrete means the same way as your wall is made of concrete and bricks. So it is, in Hindi language, I would say it is very toast, you know. So this is the way our communication should be. It should be very specific. It cannot be misinterpreted. It is clear and concrete. We are stating it with facts and figures. Now, here is an example of vague, general, indefinite sort of communication and concrete and precise communication. The sentence says, student GMAT scores are higher. The GMAT scores of students are higher. Here, if we talk about concrete and precise, in 1996, the GMAT scores averaged 600. By 1997, they had risen to 610. So in the first sentence, we are telling that the GMAT scores of students are higher. But now you're not being concrete. Being concrete means you're specifying that in this particular year, the score was this, and this particular year, it has risen to this. So your communication is concrete. Next comes completeness. Whatever message you are giving or you are sending to your sender, you are sharing, it should be complete. It should be complete in nature. It should not lack any information which could create confusion in the mind of receiver. It should convey all the facts that are required for the audience. Communication must be complete. It should convey all facts required by the audience. The sender must take into consider the receiver's mindset. So one has to take care of the audience that he is writing for or speaking to. In that case, you have to give your message completely to the audience. Now, there are features. Features are no crucial information is missing. It gives additional information and it leaves no questions unanswered. कोई भी क्वेश्चन आंसर अनआंसर्ड नहीं रहेगा रिसीवर के माइंड में. नाउ यू चेक, व्हाट डू यू सी? यू चेक फॉर 5 W's एंड 1 H फॉर कंप्लीटनेस. हु द मैसेज यू आर सेंडिंग इज फॉर हुम, व्हाट इज द मैसेज, व्हेन योर मैसेज इज गोइंग टू बी डिलीवर्ड, व्हेन यू शुड डिलीवर द मैसेज, वेयर, व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन, व्हाई एंड हाउ, व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ दिस, व्हाई इट इज बीइंग disseminated the information and how and what effect it will create in your audience behavior or attitude. Okay, next comes clarity. So clarity implies, see, you always say be clear whatever you are saying. So we have to be clear, we have to be specific, also complete in our information. Clarity implies emphasizing on a specific message or goal. Here at a time rather than trying to achieve too much at once. So we should focus on one goal rather than giving too much information at one shot. So we try to emphasize on specific message. Whatever is important, we should disseminate that. We should not proceed further. Giving too much, overloading on information should not be there. Clarity should be maintained whenever you are communicating. Clarity in communication has following features. It makes understanding easier. So the receiver is able to, the audience is able to understand properly and clearly. Complete clarity of thoughts and ideas enhances the meaning of message. Sometimes you read text and you do not understand the text or content or the message because the sender or the author writing that document is not properly able to state his mindset. Same way, when he is not clear about his content, then his audience will definitely not understand what he is trying to say. And when there is clarity of thoughts, you read some novel, you read some book, you become motivated, you are you follow the things. Why? Because the author's mind, the thoughts, the messages, that the ideas that he wanted to convey is clear. That is why you have taken a clear picture and thus has effect on your in on your behavior, your mindset, or your thoughts. Clear message makes use of exact, appropriate, and concrete words. It should have concrete words, it should be exact and appropriate as it is said. See, example, subsequent, instead of subsequent, if you write later, that would be better. Supersede, instead of circumlocating, although this is not wrong, but actually does not convey the meaning, the same meaning that you wanted to convey. So replace, using the word replace is better than supersede. Using the word show is better than disclose. Using the word try is better than using endeavor. So be clear and simple. That is the mantra, that is the rule for a better or best or effective writing. We proceed on to next one, that is concise. Now, conciseness means communicating what you want to convey in least possible way words. So whenever you have to communicate, you should not be too verbose that the audience get bored. You should be concise, appropriate to the point. The information which is important, that should be disseminated and should be complete in nature. It shouldn't be there that for completing, for being concise, you have to give incomplete information. No, that's a big no. You have to give complete information along with being precise, that is concise or brief, brevity. Conciseness is necessary for effective communication. Concise communication has following features. It is time saving. Number one, it is time saving and cost saving. Is it? Yes. It underlines and highlights the main message. Third, concise communication provides short and essential message in limited words to the audience. And the fourth, concise message is more appealing. It is more appealing to you, more comprehensible in nature to the audience. Now, eliminate wordy expressions. Use single words in place of phrases. Even Winston Churchill, very famous literaturist, made extensive use of simple and one syllabic word. Jaise ki wordy kya hai at this time, instead of that if you use now, that would be a better option. instead of using at this time. Then due to the fact that, instead of that, you can better use because. So there's no point writing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 words for a single word, which means the scene, right? So you have to, you should try to be concise wherever and whenever possible. Next. Now these are certain statements which could be helpful to understand more about how you can be concise. Due to the fact that, because that we have discussed, employed the use of used. Basic fundamentals completely eliminate fundamentals. Alternative choices, alternatives. Actual experience, experience. So there's no point writing an extra word for the same thing. So we cannot be concise. We cannot be verbose when we are talking. See the last one. In as few words as possible. If I am explaining you the thing and I am using these words, you have to be very concise. Instead of concise, you have to use few words as much as possible. Otherwise, simple is to say that you should be concise, right? Next, courtesy. Courtesy in message implies the message should show the sender's expression as well as should respect the receiver. The sender of the message should be sincerely polite, judicious, reflective, and enthusiastic. Courteous message has following features. Courtesy implies taking into consideration both viewpoints as well as feelings of the receiver of the message. Courteous message is positive and focused at the audience. It makes use of terms showing respect for the receiver of message, and it is not at all biased. Courtesy means to have a sympathetic corner for others. So when you are communicating, you should not only give or throw your viewpoint on others, but consider others' viewpoint as well whenever you are saying. So it is stepping into somebody's shoe. So whenever you are communicating, you should think of your audience, what their mindset is, what their desire is. So keeping a, you know, balance between the both, you should communicate. You should always respect the receiver that you are communicating with. Correctness. Last one is, not the last one. Correctness means whatever information you are giving, that should be exact. It should be correct in nature. Incorrect information is not, should not be there. If you're calling somebody for a meeting at 3 p.m., so correct information should be there. You should not mislead by 4, 2, or any other timing, right? Correctness in communication implies that there are no grammatical errors in communication. It has following features. The message is exact, correct, and well-timed. If the communication is correct, it boosts up the confidence level, both of the communicator as well as the listener. It goes both ends. Correct messages have great impact on audience and reader. It checks for the preciseness and accurateness of facts and figures used in the message. It makes use of appropriate and correct language in the message. So correctness should be there whenever you are communicating. Having a preciseness towards what facts you are stating, what figures you are imbibing in the message. It should be, the language should be correct, it should be appropriate, should be well timed. It is not that when the time has gone, you are sending the information at that time, or you are communicating at that time. So it should be well timed. Seeing the time and context, you should always communicate. Right form of language, accuracy, and acceptable words. Select the right level of language for your communication. So these are certain ways by which you can have correctness in a communication. That is to select the right level of language for your communication, either formal or informal, whether with a person, with the audience, or whatever your audience is, maybe your boss or maybe your junior, or maybe you are writing for mass people. So in that way, your level of language should be considered. Whether you should talk formally, whether you should talk informally, or what sort of or what mode of communication will be there. So you should consider that. You should also realize that formal language is most often used in business communication. We all know that. Check for correct figures, facts, and words. Apply the principles of communication to your writing. Considerateness. When you consider, consideration means when you consider somebody else. It means stepping into shoes of others. You consider while communicating. take note of audience viewpoint, background, mindset, educational level. You should not, you know, superimpose or thopify your communication with others. You should always take note of what your audience viewpoint is or what they desire out of you. Whatever information you are sending, you are speaking suppose an English language and you are addressing an illiterate or maybe people who have not qualified, who are not qualified much or who are not comfortable with English. So you have to always consider your audience for communicating your viewpoint. Envisage your audience, their requirements, emotions and problems. You should also consider their emotions and problems if they are facing any. Do not hurt self-respect and emotions of audience. So there are certain words which actually hurts other. See, there is a term that gender biasness is there. When we say that his viewpoint should be taken in consideration. So we use his, we do not use her. So it gender biasness nahi hui. Why don't we use a neutral term where his or her is not there, right? So we do these mistakes. So we should take care of these things, but we should use neutral terms instead of being specific to a gender. Why do we use a masculine or male gender terms, right? So this way we have to take care of while communicating. Suppose you are communicating with any physically challenged person, physically handicapped or mentally disabled person. You know, you also in your schools, students having mentally who are mentally challenged are sitting with you. So there is a term given to them, and the term so that they do not feel, because earlier when they were called mentally challenged, physically challenged, this used to hurt them, right? Because already they are deprived of one thing, and then people are saying like this, so they feel bad. So a term called special children is being given to them so that they also feel good when they are being called. So special children class, or they are special children. So these kind of terms are being used so that self-respect does not get hurt. Modify your words to suit the audience need. Features, emphasize on you approach rather than me approach. Show optimism towards your audience, positive attitude. Optimistic attitude. Empathize and exhibit interest in audience to stimulate a positive reaction. If you are positive and you are spreading positive positivity everywhere, you will definitely get back the same. So you should have an empathetic feeling towards your let's say if you're working, if you take a scenario of a company, then in a company, being a boss, you should empathize with your employees. You should consider their emotions, feelings, any state of mind in which they are not comfortable. You should empathize, you should understand and consider their mindset as well. So you should exhibit interest in audience to stimulate a positive. And definitely, if you carry on like this, you will get back the same. That is the positive, yes, I can do attitude from your employees. So that was all about 7 C's of effective business writing, and they are quite easy. These are the principles that you apply in your daily life. Now, next video will be covering the last topic of this unit, that is technical proposal, which is quite helpful for you because now second year onwards next years, you will be handling certain projects where you have to submit your proposal. So understanding proposal is quite important. Thank you so much.